Hi, folks. I'm Mel Brooks, and behind me you see my son and my grandson, and they can't be with me. Why? Because of this coronavirus. And Donald Trump's not doing a damn thing about it. So many people have died. And when you're dead, you can't do much. So I'm voting for Joe Biden. I like Joe. Why do I like Joe? Because Joe likes facts. Because Joe likes science. Joe will keep us going. Take a tip from me. Vote for Joe. Okay, that's all I gotta say. Okay, you can leave. Thank you. Thank you. See you soon. I gotta fill out my ballot. See you later. Bye-bye. Yeah, I love you too. That was good.
So that was comedy legend Mel Brooks making an endorsement of Joe Biden for president and criticizing Donald Trump in the process. Now, this is important because this is for the senior citizens. Maybe the boomers, but mostly the seniors. Because Mel Brooks is 94 years old. And if you're younger than me and maybe even my age, you might be like, who the heck is Mel Brooks? Well, he's a legendary comedian, beloved for generations. I remember seeing him do a guest appearance on The Simpsons back when The Simpsons, frankly, guys, I'm going to say it, was good still. And it was fantastic. And I was like, who's this old guy? He must have been important to my mom and to my grandmom and things like that. So when it's about appealing to seniors, the people who often vote and the people who have been affected in this particular way more than anybody else by COVID, the fact that because they are vulnerable, they have to basically stay away from their loved ones, from their family, from their friends, from their communities, from their hobbies, from just living a normal life, even more than the rest of us, this is going to matter. Again, one thing we've been seeing in this election, one of the reasons Biden is doing better is because seniors are less enamored with the Republicans than usual. You know, Trump will probably do okay with older voters, but the reason Biden might have a big victory is that more than Clinton or even Obama, he's going to clean up with voters older than 60 who do not like how the president and the Republican Party have approached this crisis. They don't like it. Remember, back all the way in February and March, you had people in the Republican Party, people like Trump, yes, but also, you know, lieutenant governors from Texas and other people basically saying that, you know, it's not worth shutting down the economy. Grandma and grandpa are basically willing to sacrifice themselves on the altar of capitalism to save the jobs of their grandchildren and their children. And of course, being told that you are worthless and that, you know, your life isn't worth saving for this crisis because, you know, the economy might take a bit of a dip and it's going to hurt the Republican chances of winning isn't something you want to hear. So this is a great, funny, succinct, you know, 1 minute or so ad telling older folks in particular, vote for Joe Biden. He'll listen to science. He's going to do everything he can to get people with their families sooner. You know, I, of course, was a Bernie Sanders supporter, and I remember how big of a deal it felt when he got endorsed by Dick Van Dyke. It was a big deal. These things matter to people. These things matter. You know, you could say, oh, it's a celebrity endorsement. Who gives a hoot, right? But it matters. When Biden needs to get one of the most reliable voting blocks in American politics, older folks who likely remember him fondly, this will resonate. It could be, you know, the thing that helps a few former Republicans pull a different lever this time around.